Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel. In today's video, we will see how to calculate the HRA of the employees. HRA means house rent allowance. Okay, so to calculate the HRA, they have given us the conditions. And based on that condition, we have to calculate the HRA. So we will see what is our conditions. So this is our salary and this is our HRA. Okay, so if employee's salary is less than 2500, then 10% HRA they will get on their salary. If employee's salary is equal to 2500 or greater than 2500, then 25% HRA they will get on their salary. So this is our conditions. We will calculate the Nikhil's HRA. So I will select the E2 set. So before calculation, we have to know which function we will use. So we will use the if function, because they told us to calculate based on the conditions. So I will type the if function format. So you can see this is a if function format. If, open the round bracket, condition, comma true, comma false, and close the round bracket. Now we will calculate the HRA of Nikhil. So I will select the cell E2. Before any calculation in Excel, we have to type is equal to sign. And based on this condition, they told us to calculate the HRA. So we will use the function if. So if, open the round bracket, and in the format you can see that it is condition. So our first condition is less than 2500. Less than 2500 is our salary, right? We are calculating the HRA of Nikhil. So we have to select the Nikhil's salary cell, that is C2. And what is our first condition? Less than 2500. So we have typed a condition. In format, after condition there is comma. So we will type comma. Next is true. If Nikhil's salary is less than 2500, then how much HRA he will get? 10%. So 10% on what he will get? Salary. So we will type 10% on what he will get? Salary. That's why we will type the multiplication sign and select the Nikhil's salary cell, because 10% he will get on his salary. So we will select C2 cell. So this is a condition and this is a true. In the format, next is comma. So we will type comma. Next is false. So you can see here we have two conditions. We have checked the first condition. If we have two conditions and we have checked the first condition, then there is no required to check the second condition. The second condition will automatically goes into false. Why? If Nikhil's salary is less than 2500, means in between 1 to 2499, then he will get 10% HRA on his salary. But if his salary is equal to 2500 or greater than 2500, like 3000, 4000, then he will get 25%. So what Excel will do? Excel will check and automatically he will give 25% to Nikhil if his salary is equal to 2500 or greater than 2500. So the second condition will automatically goes into false. So 25% into C2, because 25% he will get in on their salary. So we have select the C2 cell. Then in format you can see there is close the round bracket. So we will close the bracket and say enter. So you can see the Nikhil's HRA gets automatically calculated. When you select the E2 cell, you can see the formula which you have typed. Now we have calculated for calculated HRA for Nikhil. We have to calculate the HRA for other employees also, right? So example, suppose I want to calculate the HRA for Abhishek. What I will do? I will type the same function, right? Is equal to if, open the round bracket. Here we will type C3 because Abhishek's salary is in C3 cell. Then less than 2500, comma 10% into C3, comma 25% into C3. So here the pattern is same, only the cell name is changing. If the pattern is same and only cell names are changed, then what we can do? We can do fill handle. So how we can do fill handle? Select the cell in which you have already calculated with that format. Keep your pointer here, left click, hold and drag till where you want to calculate the HRA. You can see the Excel will automatically calculate the HRA for other employees also. Here it is C2. In Abhishek, if you select, it is C3. Here you can see it is C4. The pattern is same, only the salary cell names are changing. So this way you can calculate the HRA with the help of if function.